Welcome to RN tutorials on mechanics of fluids. And in this video lecture I am going to explain about the stability of submerged body and floating body. That means what are the conditions to be taking place for a submerged body and a floating body to be in stable equilibrium conditions, that we are going to discuss here. So first we go for stability of a submerged body. So here we can give one statement that by which reference, with what reference we can determine the stability of submerged body. Means here, the stability of a submerged body can be determined by the position of the center of balance in relation with the center of gravity. That means with the help of the center of balance position relative to the center of gravity, we can determine the stability condition for the, or we can decide the stability condition for the submerged body. Okay, here for that I am assuming a body or a balloon. Assume here, this is the balloon which is I am assuming completely submerged in the air. That means here it is simply kept in air. That means we can say that it is submerged in an air. So for this one I am assuming center of gravity position and the center of buoyancy position. Here I am assuming center of gravity position below the center of buoyancy. So in this condition only basically we get the stable equilibrium condition for the submerged body. But how we can understand that this balloon is going to be in stable equilibrium condition because of this center of buoyancy is above the center of gravity. So let us analyze. So now I try to tilt this balloon and we try to analyze the weight of the body and force of buoyancy acting through the center of buoyancy, then we can understand how the stability is going to take place for this submerged body. So here this balloon is tilted through a particular angular displacement, assume whatever the angle. So in this condition, if we try to analyze the weight of the balloon and force of buoyancy, what are the direction takes place? Means here always the weight of the body acts downward direction. So the weight of the body which is acting through G is acting downward direction, and similarly force of buoyancy acts upward direction through a point B, that is the center of buoyancy. So when you observe these two forces which are acting on the balloon, that is the body, by these two this can form a couple which is acting in anti-clockwise direction. So here we have given the angular displacement in clockwise direction. But these two forces, that is W and force of buoyancy, both are causing a couple which is acting in anti-clockwise direction. That means this anti-clockwise directional couple can try to make the body to return its original position. That means it can make the body to return back to its original position. That means it will try to make the body to the equilibrium position condition. Okay, so that means we can say that the body can be in stable equilibrium condition. So when this condition we are getting, when the center of buoyancy is above the center of gravity. Okay, so with reference to this we can give one statement, that is when the center of buoyancy is above center of gravity, then the submerged body remains in stable equilibrium condition. So in this condition only the couple formed by these two forces acts in anti-clockwise direction. So that is opposite to the tilt we have given to the body. So automatically this will try to make the body to return to its original position. So that is why we can say that the body is in equilibrium condition. Okay, next we go for another example. The same balloon I have taken, but here the center of buoyancy is lying below the center of gravity. So in this condition what it is going to happen means here the body will be in unstable equilibrium condition only. But how we can understand that this body is going to be in unstable equilibrium condition? Means again we need to analyze the couple formed by the two forces here, that is weight of the balloon and the force of buoyancy. So let us analyze that. So again the balloon is tilted through an angular displacement. So after tilting we have to analyze the directions of the forces, that is force of buoyancy and the weight of the balloon. So weight of the balloon obviously acts downward direction, and at the same time the force of buoyancy acts upward direction. So here also these two forces are making a couple, and this couple can cause the balloon to rotate in clockwise direction. Okay, when you see here, it is causing the rotation or couple in anti-clockwise direction. Here the rotation is causing in clockwise direction, whereas the tilting also we are giving in clockwise direction only. So when these two becomes in the same direction, it will cause continuous rotation or overturn of the body here, that is the balloon here. That means it won't be in a equilibrium condition, it won't be in a stable equilibrium condition. Okay, so that means when the center of balance is below the center of gravity, the body will be in unstable equilibrium condition. So again, the statement we can give, when the center of balance is below the center of gravity, then the submerged body remains in unstable equilibrium condition, because this couple is also causing the body to rotate in same clockwise direction, which doesn't make the body to return to its original position. Okay, that is the stable equilibrium condition and unstable equilibrium condition for the two submerged bodies. Okay, there is another case, which is the neutral equilibrium. So what do you mean by neutral equilibrium? Means here, when these two points B and G, that is center of buoyancy and center of gravity, both coincide with each other, then the condition can be called as neutral equilibrium condition. Okay, so that is about stability of submerged body. Next we go for stability of a floating body. So here also one statement we can give, the stability of a the floating body has to become the stability of floating body can be determined by position of the metacenter in relation to the center of gravity, whereas in submerged body it is determined with the help of the center of balance in relation to the center of gravity. But here for floating body we have to take position of the metacenter in relation to the center of gravity. So again we try to analyze that. So in a liquid or water, I am taking a floating body, and here I am assuming the center of gravity and center of buoyancy positions like this. And after that, I try to tilt this body through a particular angular displacement. Okay. So now in this condition, the center of buoyancy can change its location to B1, new location to B1. And when we try to draw a line through this B1, this line intersects at a particular point on the center of gravity line. That will be the metacenter. Okay. So in this condition, what is happening again here? We try to analyze again the force of buoyancy and center of gravity. So force of buoyancy and weight of the body here. So weight always acts downward direction through the center of gravity, that is W I am representing, and at the same time the force of buoyancy, which is acting through the new buoyancy, that is new center of buoyancy B1, which is in upward direction. Here our tilting is again in clockwise direction, but the couple that can be made by this W and FB is acting in anti-clockwise direction. That means the couple made by W and FB can make the body to return to its original position. So again we can say that the body tries to come to its original position, means here we can say that it will be in stable equilibrium condition. So now again we can give one statement that when metacenter is above center of gravity, then the floating body remains in stable equilibrium condition. Similarly, opposite to that, the unstable equilibrium condition obtains. That means if the metacenter is below the center of gravity, then the body remains in unstable equilibrium condition. So how again we analyze? Again, I'm assuming one body, floating body, which is in water. Okay, I'm assuming the center of gravity and center of buoyancy here. And now I am going to tilt the body through a particular angle here. Okay, so after tilting, again the buoyancy, center of buoyancy, changes its location to new location, that is as B1. And when you draw a line through this, this line will intersect the center of gravity line at a particular point. That point will be giving us a metacenter. Okay, so now we try to analyze the forces, that is buoyancy force and weight of the body. So that is always, you know, the weight acts downward direction through G and the force of buoyancy acts upward direction through B. So when you observe here, the couple formed by these two forces can cause the body to rotate again in clockwise direction only. Okay, so observe the variation here. The body can rotate in anti-clockwise direction due to the couple formed by the two forces here, but here the couple formed by the two forces can cause the body to rotate in clockwise direction only. Whereas we are tilting in clockwise direction, and couple is making the body to rotate in clockwise direction also. So that means it will cause the overturning of the body. So overturning means it can't be, it cannot get back to its original position. It can't be in equilibrium condition. So that is why we can say that the floating body is in unstable equilibrium condition. So statement we can give, when meta center is below center of gravity, then the floating body remains in unstable equilibrium condition. So this is about stability of floating body, which is based upon the position of the meta center in relation to the center of gravity. So there is again a case that is similar to the neutral equilibrium condition. So here the neutral equilibrium condition means the meta center and the center of gravity both should be coinciding. So when this case happens, we can say that the body is in neutral equilibrium condition. Okay, that is about stability of submerged body, stability of floating body. So I hope you understood the simple basic conditions which we can understand with the help of the couple forming due to the two forces, that is force of buoyancy and the weight of the body, based upon the positions of the center of buoyancy and center of gravity, and is meta center with respect to the center of gravity. So I hope you understood the conditions for the equilibrium of submerged body and floating body. If you still have any doubts, please feel free to give a comment to my video so that I'll try to clarify your doubts. And once again, thanks for watching my video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And thanks again. Thank you all.